What's up, guys? It's Kelly, and today I am back for another Halloween-themed Nail Art Sunday. What's up? Today I am doing these glitter skulls. They are free-handed, they're not perfect, but I had a lot of fun doing them, so I'm gonna show them to you anyway. I was kind of inspired by the polish, this OPI, which is the glittery one. I just feel like I saw it, and I was like, this would make a pretty cool skull. So this is like some glam skulls. I don't even think this has to be Halloween, you know? Some people just like to wear skulls. So if you dig it, keep on watching, I'll show you how to do it. So for this manicure, you can use whatever colors you want, but these are the ones I'm using. I am going to be going in with my Cuccio base coat. I've got Cuccio 2AM in Hollywood, OPI Super Star Status, which is the star, and my Cuccio top coat. I'm also going to be just using this random tiny little paintbrush that I got at a craft store. So I am starting off with my clean natural nail and applying my base coat. And once that is dry, I'm going to do my black nail polish as a base. So then I'm going to take a piece of scrap paper and I'm going to take some of that gold, or I don't know, is this a gold or silver, champagne? I don't know. Whatever color this is, I am going to use my little brush. Obviously, you want to make sure that your base color is dry first. And I'm going to start to freehand the skull. There's really no trick for this. What I usually like to do is I like to draw a circle to let me know where the center of the nail is. And I'm just starting off by sort of making a circle shape and then letting it trail off at the bottom. So, like I said, these aren't perfect, but the cool thing about it is because your base color is black, you can go in later, which I will be doing, and you can fix it. So it's super easy. Just honestly, I always start small and like to build up. It's not too unlike my eyeball manicure that I just recently did. I feel like it's sort of the same thing where you just start small, keep getting bigger and bigger, and then you have the shape that you want. So again, just gonna keep on working on that. I'm gonna fill it in, and it looks vaguely skull shaped, so I'm pretty satisfied with that. So I am gonna give that glitter some time to dry before I move on to the next step. I'm gonna take my scrap piece of paper again and my black nail polish, same brush which I just cleaned off using some acetone, and I am going to start to draw the eyes. And basically I'm just doing two almost teardroppy shapes. I didn't use any reference for this. You are welcome to do that. I just felt like I was just going with the flow for whatever reason. So maybe that's why it's not perfect, but I mean, it's also a lot easier to see mistakes when you're totally zoomed in like I am right now. I think if you go out with this nail art, nobody's gonna be scrutinizing it, if you know what I'm saying. So yeah, just making some nice eyeballs here and then a little nose. So just sort of like an upside down heart is the idea I was going for. And then I'm gonna do a couple of lines on the bottom just sort of to make the bottom part look like teeth. Yeah. This is an abstract skull, that's what we're going for. So like I said, you can always go back with the black nail polish and go over the parts that you might want to refine a little bit. I wanted my skull to be a tiny bit thinner and taper off a little bit stronger, so I'm just going over the edges with that. Once you cover it up with top coat, you totally won't be able to tell. And yeah, so once everything is dry, just put a nice thick layer of some gel-like top coat over it, and then there you have it, some skull nails. I did use a matte top coat for my photo, but I actually prefer this one shiny just because I love the glitter and I think it's, I don't know, pretty glam. If I was a witch, I would totally wear this. Anyway, make sure you give this video a thumbs up, let me know what you think, and don't forget to tune in for the next Nail Art Sunday. Bye!